Hi everybody, this is Indira, Assistant Professor of Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Department of Mathematics. Today, we are going to learn how to find out the Fourier series of the given function in the given interval. Already, this topic has started in the last sessions, and we have seen that the Fourier series is applicable for only periodic functions. So, to now, we are going to find out the how to apply this Fourier series for even and odd functions. So, but now, before going to apply the even and odd functions, it is very much needed to know how to find out whether the function is even and how to check whether the function is odd. Now, if suppose f of x is an even function, if f of x is an even function, if you replace x by minus x, we'll get back the original function. For example, x square is a given function. So, if I substitute minus x in place of x, I'm going to get it as minus x whole square, which is nothing but x square, which is again nothing but the original function. If this concept obeys, then that type of functions are called as the even functions. So, what is the flexibility of finding out whether the function is odd or even? Is we need to do all the three Fourier coefficients or some of the Fourier coefficients will get vanished if you know that it is even an odd function. So, let us see all the terms here. So, the function f of x is even function if f of minus x is equal to f of x. For example, f of x is equal to cos x. Cos minus theta is cos theta and x square so on. The graph of even function y is equal to f of x is symmetric about the y-axis. If the function is even function, according to the definite integrals, integral of minus a to a f of x dx is equal to twice the integral 0 to a f of x dx. So, there is a flexibility of using this formula by the definite integral if you know that the function is even or odd. Right. So, now Fourier's, let's recapitulate the Fourier series expansion of the given function f of x in any interval. Let us suppose the interval is minus pi to pi. So, let f of x plus 2 pi is equal to f of x, and the Fourier expansion is given by f of x is equal to a naught by 2 plus summation n raises from 1 to infinity a n cos nx plus b n sin nx. A naught is equal to 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x dx, and n is equal to 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x cos nx dx, and bn is equal to 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x sin nx dx. Here, a naught, an, and bn are called as the Fourier coefficients of f of x in the interval minus pi to pi. If the function is an even function, then the last Fourier coefficient bn becomes 0. So, there is no need to find out the last Fourier coefficient bn if the function is even function. So, the Fourier expansion is reduced to only, we need to find out that only two coefficients, that is a naught and bn, an value, n rises from 1 to infinity, an cos n pi nx. So, this is a Fourier expansion if the function is an even function. Only two coefficients we need to find to get out, and bn is automatically is equal to 0. So, whenever the question arises, we need to claim that it is an even function. Then we have to go with the procedure of finding out the Fourier series for the given function. So, let us take one example. Obtain the Fourier series of f of x is equal to 1 minus x square over the interval minus 1 to 1. So, the given function is even, because if you substitute minus x in place of x, we are going to get it as f of x. And here the period is nothing but the upper limit minus lower limit, that is 1 minus 1, that is nothing but 2. So, a naught is equal to 1 by 1 integral minus 1 to 1 f of x dx. Here f of x is 1 minus x square. Integral of 1 is x. Integral of x is x square x cube by 3. I mean, integral of x square is x cubed by 3. So, if you solve, this comes out to be 2 into integral of 0 to 1 f of x dx, which is nothing but 2 into integral of minus x minus x cubed by 3 from the limit 0 to 1. So, upper limit is 1 and lower limit is 0. Substitute the upper and the lower limits here. So, we are going to get it as n is equal to 1 by 1 integral of minus 1 to 1 f of x cos n pi x dx. Okay, so the a0 value we will get it as, after solving we will get it as 4 by 3. So, an value is equal to 1 by 1 integral minus 1 to 1 f of x cos n pi x dx. F of x is nothing but 1 minus x square, 1 minus x square cos n pi x dx. So, twice the integral 0 to 1, 1 minus x square cos 2n pi x dx. So, we use the integration by parts formula, integral of f into g, that is f into g1 minus f dash into g2 plus f double dash into g3, so on, where f dashes are nothing but the derivatives, g1, g2, g3 are nothing but the integrals. And f is a function which has to be taken that have the limited derivatives, and g is a continuously differentiable function we can take, right? If you take vice versa, the integral will goes on and we will get endless in terms. So, we should not do like that. So, let us do the integration by parts. So, 2 into 1 minus x square is as it is, integral of sine that's cos nx dx is nothing but sine n pi x by n pi minus derivative of 1 minus x square, that is minus 2x. Integral of sine, again the second term, we have to do it till the first term becomes 0, that many terms we are going to get it. And sine n pi x, that is nothing but minus cos n pi x by n pi whole square, plus derivation of minus 2x is nothing but minus 2. Integral of cos n pi x is nothing but minus sine n pi x by n pi whole cube from 0 to pi. So, this is the value. Now, we have to substitute the upper and the lower limit to get the final value. So, after substituting the upper and the lower limits, here we can see that there are three terms are there where the first and the last term become 0 at upper and the lower limit. So, we will get only the value for the lower middle term, that is second term. So, even that also the for higher limit we are going to get the middle term, even the lower limit. At lower limit, if you put x is equal to 0, it completely becomes 0. So, we are going to get it as 4 into minus 1 whole to the power of n plus 1 by n square pi square. So, let us go to the bn value. Bn value, we have claimed that the function is even function. So, there is no need to find out the bn value. It automatically becomes 0. So, all the three terms are ready for us and we need to substitute in the Fourier expansion, that is nothing but f of x is equal to f of x is equal to a naught by 2 plus summation n rises from 1 to infinity a n cos n pi x. So, you substitute a n and a naught and b n value, I will get it as f of x is equal to 2 by 3 plus 4 by pi square summation n raises from 1 to infinity minus 1 whole to the power of n plus 1 by n square cos n pi x. So, this is the expansion for the Fourier series it becomes very easy to find out the Fourier coefficients if you know that the function is even or odd function. It helps you to vanish one of the Fourier coefficients. Suppose by mistake if you find it also, it comes out to be 0. So, risk in order to reduce the time of solving this solution, it's better to check whether the ones if this type of functions are appeared, it's better to check whether the function is even or not by just substituting x is equal to minus x. If you substitute x is equal to minus x, if you get back the original function, it is even function. If minus of f of x we get, it is odd function. And if neither of these are there, then we can't apply all the three Fourier coefficients we need to find it out. Okay, so that like that we can find out the Fourier expansions of the given function in the given interval if you know that it is even or odd functions. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.